Hey y'all, I'm Jasmine and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, I'm gonna tell you guys a new series that I'm starting, and basically it's gonna be where I take a common medication class and tell tips and tricks or common things to know about these medications. And this is gonna not only help student pharmacists and pharmacists to know common counseling points, but also people who are starting these medications who may have some questions. So in today's video, I'm gonna detail some of the common things that are associated with antidepressants and anti-anxiety medications. But in future videos, I'm going to talk about different medication classes. So I don't have a name for my series yet. So if you guys have any good names for this series, leave them down below. But if not, I'm going to think about some really cool names to, I guess, kind of get the ball rolling. So guys, I did want to start with a disclaimer that I am a student pharmacist. I am not yet a licensed pharmacist. So while I have been taught these concepts and practiced them while a student, I have not earned my licensure in pharmacy yet. Okay, so if a patient presents to a doctor's office or a nurse practitioner and they tell them or they present with symptoms of depression or anxiety, the first class of medications typically is SSRIs, or selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, and sometimes SNRIs, and those are serotonin and norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors. So these are the first line, which means these are the first medications that we choose just because they're really effective, they have limited side effects, and overall they have a positive impact on patients. So with the SSRIs and SNRIs, there are a number of medications to choose from. I'm gonna have a list of them on the screen somewhere. I don't know where I'm gonna put it, but these are some common examples and people take them pretty often. So I'm gonna go through some of the side effects that are associated with SSRIs and SNRIs. And as a note, these are not to scare you. All these side effects are not very common, but it's just to let people know exactly what happens when taking an antidepressant. So people often wonder, what's the mechanism of these drugs? What's gonna happen when I take them? So with SSRIs, or selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, and SNRIs, serotonin and norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors, ultimately the goal is to increase serotonin and increase norepinephrine in your body so that you can increase your mood and ultimately improve your quality of life. Along with the mechanism, it's also associated with some of the side effects that you can see when taking the medication. So we're gonna go through those in a bit. So with these medications, people often think, okay, I'm gonna take the medicine, then I'm gonna feel better immediately. But that's not how it works. So with these medications, it's important to let patients know that it can take weeks to see the effects of the medications. So ultimately, I tell patients about 4 to 8 weeks before you actually notice an increase in your mood. And this is because when you first start taking the medication, there's an immediate increase in serotonin and potentially norepinephrine if you're on an SNRI. But with the increase in these chemicals, there's also a down regulation of the receptors. And ultimately, that means that there's not a lot of proteins for the medications to bind to. So with that, it takes time for these receptors to build back up and for the medication to actually work. So about 4 to 8 weeks to notice the optimal benefit of these medications. So because it does take a few weeks for these medications to start, if you don't tell people that it's going to take a few weeks, it can kind of discourage them from not wanting to take the medicine. So it's beneficial for you to tell them that it's going to take a few weeks. And along with that, it's also beneficial to let patients know that there's other ways for them to improve their mood while they're waiting on the maximum benefits of the medication. So cognitive behavioral therapy, speaking with a therapist, different things like that. These are all options for patients to, I guess, bridge their way through the 4 to 8 weeks for the medication to actually start working. So one thing people often question before starting an antidepressant, especially in adolescents or teenagers, is that there is a black box warning for increased suicidal ideation in these populations. But in reality, the increased risk of suicidal ideation is not a huge risk. Of course, it is a small risk associated with it, but it's also important to think about the risk versus benefit. So if a teenager or an adolescent is depressed and they don't take any medications, depression is also associated with an increased risk of suicidal ideation. So these are things that you want to weigh and balance out before starting the medication, especially in teenage populations. So during the first few weeks of starting any medication, but specifically starting antidepressants and anti-anxiety medications, it's important to know that your body has to adjust to these new medications being introduced to your body. So one of the things that most people don't like about starting antidepressants that will go away within the first week or so is you have some GI upset. So you may have a little bit of tummy upset when you start the medications, but I assure you that after the first 1 or 2 weeks, you won't have as many of these side effects with GI upset. And this is because you have serotonin receptors all over your body. Now, mind you, there are different types of serotonin receptors, but if you have an increase in serotonin, then all the other receptors can be activated and ultimately lead to some side effects. So you do have serotonin receptors in your GI tract, in your stomach area, your gut. So that's why a lot of people experience GI upset. So with these medications, there is going to be an increase in chemicals in your central nervous system, and ultimately that's what you want. You want your mood to be improved, you want to improve your quality of life, you want to make sure that your depression slash anxiety and or anxiety is at bay. But with that, during the first few weeks, there can be some paradoxical effects. Basically, there can be some opposite effects of what you want to happen. So you may have some sleep disturbances or some sleep changes. You may have some insomnia, some sedation. That's pretty common in the first few weeks. And you may also have some increased anxiety, and that's just because your body is taking time to adjust to the new medication. But ultimately, after the first few weeks, you will notice that these symptoms should kind of resolve or go away. So one of the things that's not very sexy about taking antidepressants is that you can have some sexual adverse side effects, and ultimately you can have some reduced libido, or your drive to engage in sexual encounters may be lower. It impacts different patients differently, obviously, but there is a risk of sexual side effects with antidepressants and anti-anxiety medications. And that's not to say that everybody on these medications experiences these side effects, but there is a slight risk once taking them. So I did want to highlight that the way that your physician or your pharmacist or your nurse practitioner, physician assistant, basically however a provider chooses your medication, can also be dependent upon other comorbid conditions or other disease states that you have. So for example, if you are a patient who's experiencing depression, but you also have hypertension or high blood pressure, your doctor or physician provider might want to avoid SNRIs because the norepinephrine can increase your blood pressure. So also, if you have conditions like chronic pain or neuropathic pain, SNRIs can be beneficial because norepinephrine has been associated with a reduction in pain. So ultimately, chronic conditions can inform the types of medications that your doctor chooses. So thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope you guys learned something about antidepressants and anti-anxiety medications. I did want to emphasize though that these medications are incredibly important, and they can dramatically improve the quality of life of patients with depression and anxiety. So please do not let any of the side effects and things like that impact your decision to start any of these medications, because they can have a dramatic impact on your life. So with that, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what types of videos you want to see, what medication classes you want to see next. But in the meantime, just watch another video. They're going to be on the screen pretty shortly. Thanks for watching, y'all. So SSRIs, or selective serotonin, a new series, that's the word, that with these medications you can have some, what's the word I'm looking for? Somnolence.